Thank you, you guys, for coming and spending your time to listen to my speech. To this day, I remember sitting in my elementary class, staring at the scribbles my teacher was writing on the chalkboard. And I remember thinking, what was she doing? The lines were all connected, some pointy and curvy. I remember hearing handwriting in cursive. As we were taught how to write the letters, we slowly made them into words, and from then on, I loved making those curvy and pointy lines. Learning how to write cursive not only helps our writing to look more polished, but can also be able to read historical documents like the Declaration of Independence. It is also good for our fine motor skills and to retain more information and ideas. I myself, like everyone else, was taught how to write in cursive, and now that my children are in school, I am hearing that there are some schools not teaching cursive. As a parent, I want my children to learn this art and feel that it is important. Have you ever wondered why and should children learn cursive? Do you feel that since technology is now the main way to write letters to communicate through email, that it doesn't matter? Do we need to learn cursive in a digital world? What will happen to our country when no one could read historical documents from our forefathers or diary entries from our ancestors? In the end, I was sure why children and adults should learn how to read and write cursive in school while living in a world of technology. Despite being able to use a computer, a person will always need the ability to put their thoughts down on paper. In a 2013 article, Why Does Cursive Need to Be Taught in the Digital Age? Cindy Long points out that the Common Core standards did not include cursive handwriting, and it opened a debate among state legislators. In 2010, nationwide, Common Core standards took out handwriting in elementary curriculums and had it only in lessons for kindergarten and first grade. Not long after, other states went against the change and made bills that required handwriting and cursive a part of every school day, long 2013. Saying that millennials are being taught cursive, then it becomes less important and that more documents are being typed out on computers. That the day and age children are growing up are less on books and chalkboards, but more on tablets and computer screens. Research conducted by Nelson found that the average American adult spends over 11 hours a day in front of a screen. Even though we are all on computers and tablets more hours throughout the day, does not mean we are all pros in typing, and that is another story as well, around 2015. Being able to use a computer and to write and read cursive is a skill we all need to be able to do. What we don't realize is that not only does cursive keep us connected to the past, to be able to read old documents and to sign our name, it also helps our brains to be challenged. It all has helped those who have suffered from brain injuries that damage their ability to read and write, but to also understand print and to teach children who have dyslexia. Should we learn to write cursive? An education expert weighs in. Maddie Crum said that children with dyslexia have an easier time forming words with connected fluent letters. It engages multiple areas of the brain and muscles to help remember specific letters. Crum, 2015. Our brains are able to make connections and to be challenged as we write in cursive. This debate can go back and forth, left and right. But is there a right answer? In the end, it is a matter of opinion and on the individual. Even if we do teach our children cursive as they grow up, they eventually adjust how they write cursive. Cindy Long has said that some adults eventually abandon cursive and start writing a hybrid of mostly print letters and print letters joined occasionally in a cursive style. Long 2013. Are you guilty of that? Because 55% of adults write in hybrid and 37% write in cursive. I sometimes write in hybrid cursive, and there have been times when it is just convenient and faster to write it out. But when I see others who actually take the time to write cursive the way it is supposed to be written, I am in awe and jealous of their skills. Being able to read cursive, we are able to write it as well. Even though in our world is turning more to technology, does not mean it will take the place of being able to read and write in cursive. If you are into genealogy, all the writing and deciphering words are in cursive.
Hey.
Michael Soule said, children who cannot read cursive won't be able to read the Constitution, the Declaration of Independence, anything that was written during the 19th century, Tom 2017. Our country was founded on documents that were written in cursive, and it is not just a way for writing words, but a method of communication with historical, scientific, and educational importance to all, Tom 2017. I have done indexing only a couple of times in the past couple of months, and when I have, I love seeing how beautiful the words connect and flow together. But because I do not write the letters correctly when I write in cursive, I have a harder time reading what the index cards are saying, which worries me because I don't ever want to write the wrong letter, and there have been times in my own ancestor information that a few letters were wrong because of a person wasn't able to read the handwriting. We may feel that having this skill is useless, but in reality it is important and it can affect others as well. In conclusion, cursive is an important skill to have and needs a place in our world of technology. Being able to write and read sets us apart from other mammals and not only leaves beautiful writing, but also challenges our minds as well. It may even look like scribbles or chicken scratches. In the 1950 Times story about a calligraphy challenge, the colonists concluded more important than the judge's verdict was the evidence that the Commonwealth's future leaders would continue to write a clear and handsome handwriting.